Hello everyone, thanks for joining me today at NASA Langley Research Center for a fun activity based on aeronautics. Here at NASA, we design, develop, and test advanced technologies that will make aviation much more environmentally friendly, maintain safety in more crowded skies, and ultimately transform the way we fly. Airplanes of the future may look very different from those of today. Be sure to check out some of our newest experimental aircraft on and off this planet. Now today we're going to try a unique wing shape, the ring wing. So try saying that three times fast. We're going to make and test a ring wing glider. All you need is a single sheet of 8.5 by 11 paper, a measuring tape, and if you like, a little piece of clear tape. To take this activity a step further, you may also want a few other types of paper to experiment with. Now, for younger students, we have a template you can print out and use instead of a piece of plain paper. Okay, NASA challenges you to use engineering design principles to turn a piece of paper into an experimental wing for a new type of aircraft, designed to be more economical and efficient than today's airliners. Are you ready? First step, take your piece of paper and fold it diagonally lengthwise, like so. Doesn't have to be perfect. For those of you using the template, you'll fold along the dashed line. Next, you'll make a half inch fold along this previously folded edge. So for me, that's about the width of my index finger. So I'm just gonna lay that down so that I get an idea of how far it needs to go. Now, if you're using the template, you'll be folding again on the second fold. So you'll be folding over once and then folding over twice. Finally, curl the ends of the paper to make a ring and tuck one end into the fold of the other. Notice how I've kept the folds on the inside. Now, if you like, you can add a piece of tape to be sure that it doesn't come apart when you fly it. Just make sure you only use a little tape, because it will add weight to your glider. In order to throw your glider, gently grasp the V between the two crown points with your thumb and index finger. Toss the glider lightly forward. You may have noticed that the folds in the paper make the airplane's front end heavy and the back end light. Curling the ends to make a ring changes the shape of the wing and improves the wing's flight performance. Okay. Once you've practiced a few flights, it's time to test. Fly your glider at least 3 times and record how far it went and anything else you notice about its flight. You can actually find the average distance your glider flew by adding up the 3 distances and then dividing by 3, the number of times you threw it. Now it's time to evaluate your design. What did you notice about the flight of your aircraft? Does it repeat a pattern each time you fly it? Try making one change to your aircraft to enable a change in its flight. Then fly your aircraft several times. How did the flight characteristics change with your design change? What is the cause-effect relationship between your change and the flight change? Like any NASA engineer, I encourage you to investigate other variables by keeping an engineering log of your changes and quantifying your changes by measuring them. Only change one variable at a time. Try different diameters and weights of paper, or vary the folds. See what happens and design what you think is the best glider possible. Thanks for joining me, and if you enjoyed this activity, visit NASA's Aeronautics website.